Assalamu alaikum. I am Amiyo Bhattacharjee. I will take a class of higher mathematics for the class 9.
Okay.
We will discuss some MCQs today.
Dear student, you know you have MCQ examination tomorrow. So, I think you all are prepared. What will you do? Anyway, you have to practice the maths, okay? From the exercise and also maths of examples, you must go through it, okay? Now, suppose 12 plus 24 plus 48. Okay. Which term is 768? Can you do it? Which term is 768? What I told you then? It is what? A equals to 12. Now you have to determine that it is an arithmetic progression or geometric progression. There is arithmetic series or geometric series. That means if we multiply 12 by 2, we get 24. If we again multiply 24 by 2, then we'll get 48. That means it is a geometric series. Now, what is R? R equals to what? R means common ratio. Common ratio means what? Second term by first term. That is 24 by 12 is equal to 2. You understand? 24 by 12 equals to 2. Now, let the nth term is 768. Okay. So what is the formula of nth term? Can you tell me what is the formula of nth term? Nth term means AR to the power n minus 1 is equal to 768. What is the value of A? That means A is 12. What is R? R means 2. To the power n minus 1 is equal to 768. Now if we divide 768 by 12, we will get, that means what? 64. That means 2n minus 1, 64 means what? 2 to the power 6. 2 to the power 6 equals to 64. So from here we can write n minus 1 equals to 6, that is n equals to 7. So the nth term is 768. Nth term, that means 7th term. 7th, I wrote here, nth term is 768. That means the value of n is here as by 7. So it is 7th term is 768. Suppose it is 1010 like this, okay, this type of. The question is 100,000th term equals to what? Question is 199th term equals to what? This is the question, okay? What will you do, my dear students? What will you do? See, it is what? 1 0 1 0. That means every even number is 0. What we have come to know, every even terms, every even terms, even is 0, and every odd, that means it is the, I am writing you 1 0 1 0. This is the first position. This is in the second position. This is in the fourth position, and this is in the third position. Okay, first, second, third, fourth, in this way. And we see that this one and these three, they are odd number. Okay, so these are odd terms. Odd terms. The word is odd. I'm not playing numbers, odd terms. Okay, that is the position, depending on their positions. Okay, so this is 1, this is 3, and this is 2, this is 4. They are even. So every odd term here is 1. Have you seen? 1, 1. Okay, and every even term here is 0. So question number A, our answer is, this is what? Even. This is what? Even. So when it is even, it is answer is 0. And when it is odd, its answer is 1. Okay? So we have got again, suppose n of A equals to A, n of B equals to B, A intersection B equals to empty set, n of A union B equals to what? Okay? What will you do for doing this math? What will you do for doing this math? Okay? Suppose A intersection B equals to empty set. You know what is N of A intersection B? That they have told you it is 0. That is, there is no element. Okay? So number of elements is here as well, 0. Now we get N of A union B equals to N of A, N of B minus N of, this is the formula, N of A intersection B. Okay, so what is N of A? What is N of A? N of A is given as by A, N of B equals to B, and it is what? N of A intersection B equals to what? 0. So our answer is A plus B. Okay, our answer is A plus B. Suppose another math can be given like that. N of A equals to 5, N of A union B equals to 12, A intersection B equals to empty set, N of B equals to what? Now do it. You just do it. I want to see that who can do it. Please do it. Okay, the same thing here what we get, the same thing, okay, the same formula here is to be implied. Now what you get here, n of a union b, it is given what, n of a union b equals to what, 12, n of a equals to 5, n of b equals to, we don't know, this is 0, okay. So from here we can write that is n of b equals to 7. So math is done, okay. Dear students, from this exercise you all must read the associative law, the distributive law, this type of, and you have De Morgan's law, okay, De Morgan's law, you know. So you must go through all these maths. Suppose okay, you know it, that means suppose it is 2, it is 3, it is 4, suppose it is 9, it is suppose 7, it is suppose 5, okay, and it is suppose 10, it is A, suppose B, it is C, or you name it, we name it, it is suppose maths for math, Bangla, and it is suppose English. M for math, B for Bangla, E for English. Okay? Have you seen? Okay. M for math, B for Bangla, E for English. Okay. Okay, if I tell you how many students have taken only one subject, for the question, only one subject, number one. Only one subject. How many students have taken only one subject? Only one. You see, this 9, this 7, and this 10. Okay, this 9, they have not taken Bangla and English. This 7, they have not taken Maths and English. In this way, okay, this 10, they have not taken math and Bangla. So what will be our answer? Our answer is 9 plus 7 plus 10 equals to what? Equals to 9 plus 16, 26. Okay. If we write how many students have taken only two subjects? How many students have taken only two subjects? You understand? Two subjects, that means what? Two. Only, the word is only two subjects, that means these three, these four, and these five. Okay? These three, these four, and these five. That means 3 plus 4 plus 3 plus 4 plus 5 equals to. Okay? If I tell you to determine how many students have taken Bangla and English, how many students have taken Bangla and English but not maths, okay, Bangla, how many students have taken Bangla and English but not maths? How many students have taken Bangla and English? This is Bangla and English. Okay. At first, I have to see how many students have taken Bangla and English. You see Bangla and English. Okay. Bangla and English. There are 7 students here. They are Bangla and English. Students here who have taken Bangla and English, okay, but what is written here? Bangla and English but not maths. Here these two have taken maths, these two have taken math, because it is inside math, okay. Here these two have taken math, okay. So this is the answer is only 5. Answer is only 5. Okay. So this type of math may be given in your examination. Okay. So you have to be very serious. You see, okay, question number 1. Suppose a perpendicular has been drawn. A perpendicular has been drawn here like this. And its name is D. Okay, suppose a perpendicular has been drawn. Two perpendiculars, okay, from A and from B. The question is orthogonal projection, okay, of AB on CB. Equals to what? A semi-produced. Okay, can you tell me? Please try to understand. We have to determine the orthogonal projection of AB. You just give focus that whose orthogonal projection is to be found. We have to determine the orthogonal projection of AB. So what will you do from A? This is from A. This is A. And this is B. From A and B, you have to draw two perpendiculars to meet at a point. Okay? You understand? We have drawn two perpendiculars from the point A and also from the point B. And where they have met? They have met at the point D. Okay, that's good. So, what are the perpendiculars here? We have drawn one of them is AD. Yes? And the other one is BD. Now you see along CB, which one of these two lines? You understand? Along CB, which one of these two lies? Which one? This is definitely BD. So our answer is BD. Our answer is BD. Write down. Here our answer is BD. Answer is BD. If you don't understand, you can just write me. If you don't understand, you can write me. I am repeating. Whose orthogonal position is to find? At first, you have to think. Okay? Our answer is AB. That AB's orthogonal position is to find. Okay? From AB, we have taken two perpendiculars, AD and BD, two perpendiculars have been drawn, okay? Anyway, now, one CB, you see, out of these two, which one lies along CB or on CB? Out of these two, which one lies along CB or on CB? So our answer is BD, that BD lies on along CB. So we have got how to determine the orthogonal projection. Okay, have you got it? That's good. Now, number 2. Suppose it is 120 degree. It is 120 degree. You understand? Again, suppose it is given AB equal to 6 cm, CB equals to 4 cm. Now the question is, now number two, the question is, what is the length of BD? BD equals to what? The question is, BD equals to what? Okay. Tell me,
what is the length of BD?
Okay, what is the length of BD? Can you find it? Not a matter. What you see here? If it is 120 degree, then it is 60 degree, right? You see, it is 6 centimeter and it is 4 centimeter. Now you see, what is the formula? We have to find this, so it is base and it is hypotenuse. So cos, write down, cos 60 degree is equal to, cos 60 degree equals to what? BD, that is base, base by hypotenuse. Have you seen? Cos theta equals to what? Base by hypotenuse. Cos theta equals to what? Cos theta equals to base by hypotenuse. That means cos 60 is, value is half, cos 60 equals to what? Half. And BD, we don't know. And what is AB? AB equals to 6. So we can get here BD equals to 3 centimeter. Okay. So our answer is 3 centimeter. Our answer is 3 centimeter. You have to apply the trigonometric ratio. Okay, here. Cos theta. Now, the question is, question number 3. The question may be given, what is AD? What is the length of AD? AD equals to what? AD equals to what? AD equals to what? We can write here that AD square by Pythagoras theorem, AD square equals to AB square minus BD square, okay? AB square minus BD square. That means AB equals to what? Given 6 centimeter. So 6 square, what is BD? BD has been found as by 3 centimeter, 3 square. That is 36 minus 9, that is 27. So AD equal to root over 27 centimeter. So we have got that AD equals to root over 27. So our answer is here, it is 3 centimeter. It is root over 27 centimeter, okay? Is it? Okay. Now, the question may be given like this. AC equals to what? Question number 4. What is the length of AC? AC equals to what? Can you tell me, please? AC equals to what? Yes, AC square is equal to, by Pythagoras theorem, we can write AD square plus CD square. This is written on the basis of Pythagoras theorem. AC square equals to AD square plus CD square. What is AD square? That is root over 27 whole square. And what is CD? CD means what? CD. This is CD. That means 4 plus 3. CD means what? 4 plus 3. This is 4. 4 plus what? 4 plus 3. 4 plus 3. That is CD. So we can write CD equal to 7 whole square, right? That means 27 plus 49 equals to what? That is 76. So AC can be written root over 76 like this. And from here we can write 4 into 19, that means 2 root over 19 centimeter. Okay, 2 root over 19 centimeter. 2 root over 19 centimeter. Now, if the question is given like this, suppose a question is given like this, this is done. Another question, okay, you understand? Here it is D, it is E, it is F, it is suppose D, E, F, D, E, F, they are what? Midpoints. Midpoints, okay? Here Z is the centroid. Centroid, centroid means where the medians meet. Where the medians meet. Where the three medians of a triangle meet is called the centroid. Okay. Suppose AD equals to some values are given. AD equals to 4 centimeter. B equal to 5 centimeter. And CF equals to 7 centimeter. The question is, what is the length of AB square, BC square? Can you find it? Can you tell me, please? Okay, perhaps you cannot. You see, what is the formula? 3 into AB square, BC square, AC square is equal to 4 into AD square, B square, C square. This is the formula. Formula, okay. So we can put the value here for AD. AD means what? AD equals to 4. This is 4. AD equals to 4. That is 4. B equals to 5. That is 5. And CF equals to 7. This is 7. And we are getting here by calculation. 4 square, 5 square, 7 square. Like this, 4 square, 16, 5 square, 25. This is 49. Okay. So this is 16 plus 25. 16 plus 25 equals to 41. 41 plus 49, that is 90. 4 into 90. 4 into 90. So from here we can write AB square, BC square, and AC square is equal to, okay, these three will be in the denominator of the right hand side. That is 4 into 90 by 3 equals to what? 30, 120 degree, sorry, 120. You understand? 120. And vice versa maths can be given, okay, to determine AD square plus B square plus C square. This is the formula, this is the relation between the side and medians. This is the formula to have an establishment between the side and the medians. Okay. 3 times the sum of the squares of the sides is equal to 4 times the sum of the square of the medians. 4 times the sum of the square of the medians. Okay. some students have written in the comment box to do maths from exercise 8.1. Okay, I did too many maths from exercise 8.1 in my some previous classes. Even after that, suppose 5 by pi radian in degree, what will you do? What will you do? And what you know? We know that 180 degree equals to pi radian, okay? Is it? That means pi radian equals to 180 degree. That means 1 radian equals to pi by 180 degree, okay? Is it? So, we can write here 5 by pi radian is equal to pi by 180 into, is it? Have you got it? Degree. Pi will be omitted. Pi by, that is what, 1 by 36. Now take out the calculator. All of you are required to take out the calculator. Calculator means what? That is, I am going to calculator. Take out the calculator. I am going to use the calculator. Okay, 1 by 36. 1 divided by 36 equals to what? 0. It is equal to 0.27777 like this. Okay, degrees. You understand? But if you are told to convert this degree into minute and second, then what will you do? See in your calculator, though it is not my calculator, in your calculator there is a sign of this type of sign, like this. You have a sign like this, this sign, okay? This type of sign is in your calculator. You just operate that button, okay? Then I have got it as y. 0 degree 1 minute, 0 degree 1 minute 40 second. Okay, if you use the calculator, you will get the value 0 degree 1 minute 40 second. You understand? Suppose you know it and you read it in class 8, diameter of a wheel is 10 centimeter. Okay, diameter of a wheel is 10 centimeter. Question number A, its circumference, what is the circumference? What is the circumference? Circumference formula is 2 pi r, okay? 2 pi r. What is the formula of circumference? 2 pi r. So, it is given diameter, right? Diameter. So, diameter is 10 centimeter, 2 r into pi. Have you seen? 2 r. 2 r means what? 2 r means what? Diameter. That is 10. And what is pi? Pi means 3.1416. Equal to what? 31.416 approximately. At the centimeter. Okay. So we can easily find it. That is, the circumference is 31.416. So you did it in class. 8. This type of math was given there. Now, suppose it is 4 p.m. Angle between the hands, hands means here our hand and minute hand. Angle between the hands equals to what? Angle between the hands equals to what? That day I tried my level best to make you understand that theta is equal to 30 hours minus 11 by 2 minute degree. You understand? This is the formula. Theta equals to what? 30 hour minus 11 by 2 minutes. So we get 30 hours. 30 hours means what? 4 hours and there is no minute. So that is, it is 0. Okay, there is no minute. That is what? 120 degree. So our answer is done. Our answer is done. You understand? Suppose it is 5:15 p.m. What is the angle between the hour hand and minute hand? What is the angle between the hour hand and minute hand? You see, theta equals to what? Theta equals to 30 hours minus 11 by 2 minute. Okay? That means here 30 hours is 5. 30 into 5. 30 into 5 minus 11 by 2 into minute. Minute equals to what? 15 degrees. Okay? Now calculate. You calculate this. All of you are required to calculate now. That means what? 150 minus that is 165 by 2 degrees. Okay, that means 300 minus 165 by 2 degrees. 300, that means 135 by 2. 135 by 2 degrees equals to what? Equals to what? 135, is it? Yes. 6 to the 12, 167.5 degree. 67.5 degree. But this is to be converted, this is to be converted into minute, degree, minute and second. Then what will you do? You just take the calculator again. You just take the calculator. Okay, have you taken the calculator? This type of math will be given in the examination. Yes, you know. You just divide 135 divided by 2. 135 divided by 2. Okay, I have written 135 divided by 2 is equal to what? You will get 67.5. Okay. Now, there is a sign, you see, degree, minute and second. There is a sign like this. Degree, minute and second. There is a sign, okay? You just operate that button, okay? Okay. That means 67 degree, 30 minute. 67 degree, it means 67 degree, 30 minute, 0 seconds, okay? 67 degree, 30 minute, 0 second, okay? Suppose you are again told to add 10 degree, 41 minute, 37 second plus, okay? 20 degree, 20 minute, suppose 25 second equals to what? Okay, do it. Is equal to what? Can you do it? Okay. You just take out the calculator. Okay. You just take out the calculator. I am giving you the operation. How to do it? How to do this math? Okay. Take out the calculator. Okay. See. The operation is like that. 10. That sign, 41, that sign, 37,
that sign plus 20 that sign, then again 20 that sign, 25 that sign equal. You understand? Okay, let's do together. It is 10. I have written 10. That sign has been given. Then 41. That sign has been given. Then 37. Okay, that sign has been given. Then plus 20 degree. Okay, then 20 minutes, then 25 seconds is equal to 31 degree, 2 minutes, 2 seconds. 31 degree, 2 minutes, 2 seconds. This is the answer. You understand? It is possible to have the subtraction as well. Okay, it is possible to have the subtraction as well. Suppose this is a hill. This is a hill. Okay. And one is here. It is 750 kilometer, and the angle here is suppose 32 minutes. Now actually what is happening, you know, if we have the center here and if we try to draw a circle like this, this type of, okay, we can draw a circle like this. Now it becomes the radius. It is radius, okay, and here it is s. We have to determine the height of the hill, okay. So what is our first duty? This is theta equals to 32 minutes. 32 minutes equals to what? 32 by 60 degree, you understand? And even we know that it is to be converted into radian always. That day I told you that this degree, okay, must be converted into radian. This degree must be converted into radian. That means 32 by 60 pi by 180 radian. Pi by 180 radian, okay. Now, we know S equals to what? R theta, this is the formula. S equals to R theta. And here what is R? R is 750. Here R is 750. And what is theta? Theta equals to 32 by 60 into pi by 180. It is kilometer. Okay. So this is the way. Now you use the calculator to get the result. Okay. Now it depends on using the calculator. Okay. Dear students, no more today. Thank you very much that you all were with me. Assalamu alaikum. Best of luck. Bye bye.